Green do it at times. David P. We also saw Wardell, obviously, most notably doing. Mummy has to back off as the turret is actually doing a bit of damage there. Mummy almost falls to the turret. We did watch Cutler die to a turret yesterday, or if not the day before. It's quite entertaining. But it's even strength currently. 4-on-4. We've got TenZ in this position. And there's targets on both sides of the arch, with one as well up on catwalk, only one playing over on A. Reyna. FNS spotted out by TenZ eventually, and that patient play, next success. There's a nice nade coming in.
30 seconds left.
Force one up onto the bench. The Kench bench doesn't provide any safety, but food is there to gobble up TenZ. And now food has to worry about them pushing through. Can step into his own flames, obviously, to try and grab up that bulldog that's waiting. He's trying to, but that rifle is being guarded as if it's made out of pure gold. And food has to take a straight fight with Relyks. Go down to just that last possible second. Nice dash away from the jet to escape harm.
30 Weiss seconds left.
Get that flash to fade quickly, and that results in two kills here for Cloud9 as ENV has been reduced to 3. FNS now trying to sneak over to the B site. Just might spot the spike as it comes around the corner. No! The timing at least initially worked out for the B, but now the time is continuing to be a problem. They may have just lost this round because they couldn't get the spike on the site. Remember, we mentioned it. Time is so problematic for them. TenZ has to go big. No! TenZ gets a little bit overeager. He dealt there as well. The food is trying to spam through the wall. They're trying to take out that Killjoy ult, and they actually do have a player who's trapped in it. Food, trying to get away, ends up getting gunned down. There's also a nano swarm in position.
One player remaining.
Yet again, ENV looks spike soft planted. As TenZ is popping off. It's down and now just one. It's FNS who's hiding inside the dark cover. And yeah, there's TenZ finding a 4K on the round.
And ENV just held that good. So 4-2 right now. We have Kaboose that's going to push forward and get that first frag. And he caught him off position, off guard right now, due to that Hunter's Fury.
mummAy has to back off as the paint shells land right next to him. FNS lurking in that corner, able to pick up one. Now TenZ has the AWP and the Blade Storm. Hyper Cage is going to go down, and mummAy gets a little bit of a sneak peek.
The wall is in a tough corner right now.
FNS, oh, just looks the wrong way, and like you mentioned, the timing works out. There's the flash lead in as well. It blinds Relyks a bit.
Just over.
In that time, he just picked off Mitch. TenZ coming through the market, though. It's a quick pickup. They've got to deal with Food, who's on the back end of this play, but Food isn't a meal. He's a snack, and he's gobbled up. So it'll be a round coming in with the spike being planted for Cloud9 Blue over on the B site. They're going to turtle up inside the boathouse, and you've got Rolling Thunder. Vice is ready to let loose. They're starting to work their way in. You heard the Empress pop. It's all about timing currently. There's the Showstopper as well. A lot of bolts being potentially thrown out here on the round. There's the Rolling Thunder coming in, but it misses Kaboose, who now uses the Dismiss to get into position, but it's a quick shot from TenZ. It puts everything on the remaining two. Curveball not in the right spot, but it is this time of TenZ with a blind shot. It's now down to the Spike Diffuser. He's sticking in, and TenZ with the jump shot. It's a miraculous play from TenZ, and the Jet starting things off. Stuck inside the Cloudburst, and the flashes prove to be a little bit too much for them to deal with. Kaboose is around the corner. It's mummy with the backup from on high. Shinobi with the blind kill through the dark cover. Well, now pop the ult to port away. Cypher is in position. Yeah, that gets canceled. So now Shinobi has to try to make it work, as Shinobi did not pick a safe position to pop that ult. Just dropped it in the middle of sight, and with 13 seconds left, this is the right play.
10 seconds
hide
left.
Hide in the corner and hope to God they don't clear it.
Oh, they'll chase it for sure. Big shadow step, but that's too late. Food's already around the corner. I think
the shadow step got screwed up. It like sent them all about the read. And you've got TenZ now about to expose himself to Kaboose. And Kaboose just takes the guaranteed kill. Going to start going back towards the B side to try and group up with the rest of the squad. They don't even need his help. As Food and FNS go big on the defense, they're going to have to start going into patterns. Cloud9 flat. Nice shot coming out from mummAy to pick off Vice. It's a quick flick in, moving up catwalk, and a nice escape as well. As the awkward off-omen player manages to escape. Now, TenZ does not have the same luck. The Killjoy ult will at least open up the defense just a bit. It's going to shove them into hell, and Kaboose is actually able to pick one off. He uses the dismiss to get a little closer. But it's all up to Relyks now. Relyks with 21 HP. Nice shooting onto his first target, Kaboose, but there's another one in the same position, and Crash
can play turtled up inside the site at Bolt House, and the turret is going to be the first point of contact to get that information. And then you have the kits, the flash points from Vice, the double peaks that could come through across as well. And when the turret is going to spot some players on that sidewalk, where you're going to see basically the nano storm pop out and allow your to kill some time for your teammates to rotate over. So let's see how ENV will attack into the site, and it starts off with a win attack.
Food runs in, hits the switch after flipping the switch on his ult. Mitch will get the openers though for Cloud9 as they cement themselves as a defensive force to be reckoned with. It's down to just one.
Wow.
Despite all the effort, all that fluff and thrill coming in from ENV as a flawless round victory. Shrug aside as being like, well, we get to start on the defense, so we're fine. There is an alarm bot down, and that's going to spot them out. Mitch now gets the intel. Great flash. Nice setup and a follow-up paranoia as well with the double flashpoint. Really well played from Cloud9. A solid setup in mid that prevents ENV from really being able to gather up control.
Yeah. Again, as Cloud9 was able to sell that fake that previous, or sorry, ENV was able to sell that fake on that previous round, we readapted here for Cloud9. Look at how far back you have Vice playing. He's playing on the staircase here of B, and is still able to flashpoint for Mitch as soon as the alarm bar gets peeked out. And he saw three players there.
30 seconds
left. He could have
been
dead to rights if a flash wasn't there. So thankfully, they're able to run that utility together and get that first kill. Make it a 5v4 situation where finally they're turtled back into the site where they've been such a huge anchor with this double play too.
Nowhere to run!
Position from Mitch should work out nicely. This is a great ult coming out from Crashies though, as ENV manages to crack into that B site despite the early presence from Cloud9 in mid. And now they've got the spike down as well. No ults available for anyone at this point, so it's just a game of rifles, and there's Shinobi picking up that first kill. Hot Hands Ghost does go down top stairs, coming in from Phoenix on site. They're just starting to work their way through. TenZ with the
rebound.
Doesn't stand a chance, and now it's all on Crashies. He snuck inside the dark cover. As great as a push it was from ENV to get onto the site after
they get a plant where it's going to be the retake play again, but you do have alert with this Spectre.
Get out of my way.
Crashies does a little bit of work. Does take down Shinobi twice.
Initiated.
With a quick response. Oh, I like the way this ult comes through, because it has a little bit more height than one might anticipate. He tried to spam through that wall, and it really wouldn't work out so well for you. TenZ flies in with the knives out. Yeah, that doesn't work out well at all, despite the fact...
the IGL for ENV. Because of that, when he had the blade storm come through, well, he got trapped by the trap wire on that retake, and that's how they're able to trade that. But this round, though, a trade after trade of 4v4, but low HP on the defense is going to be Relyks.
Off your feet!
Nice rocket coming out around the corner from Relyks.
One player remaining.
Doing great work as the Killjoy yet again. And there's the quick peek coming out from TenZ. A fast round.
So that he's able to help, have some help. And also now hold their ground. And be with the pistols.
Vice. Trying to dodge the pulses, but it's not working out so well. Kaboose goes for the heal over the dismiss, and it backfires as he's dispatched of by Mitch. They're still trying to work their way onto the site, and Mitch is just anchored in the boathouse. Relyks from distance. Let's get a kill onto Food. Mitch shot, though. Oh, there you go. It's actually Food who falls there in the end. Food was the one that picked up
30
the kill
seconds
onto
left.
Relyks. mummAy decides, hey, I'm going to take the guarantee and go for the spike plant over on A. Got a rifle. It's all about timing. TenZ is there just a little too quick. That's a real ballsy peek, by the way, coming in from TenZ with just 15 HP. Had he been prepared, he brings it down to a one-on-one where he actually has the HP advantage.
Free. Thankfully, nobody was there to trade off, but they're pushing aggressively for ENV inside this A site. Mitch is playing at the bottom here of hell. There's an opponent just across the corner, but it gets dismissed away, and mummAy moves forward. So somehow this is working out here for ENV with such an aggressive push towards the A side. Now Relyks is just going to be the last man standing on a 4-1. Does have a showstopper, but it's looking for the last one, and it is, and it will be for ENV.
It's interesting to say that the way that it plays, it actually blocks out mid, but it's actually TenZ that goes down, and oh no, not like this. They got so close. Surely it can't end this way.
30 seconds left.
ENV has a 5-on-3 as they start to work their way into B. The spike's going to be planted, and Kaboose has one hell of a flank. It's an easy kill onto Relyks. A dismiss to get away. There was another target inside the market. It's Shinobi, but it's all falling apart. It's now down to just Shinobi, and what can he do? Takes out the first target. There's a Phoenix flying in with a flashbang.
Well, they pay the price. Cloud9 feeds into that and get the first kill. Now they stack the sights and have the numbers advantage.
TenZ still here. TenZ just feeling it. Decides to just get aggressive. Throws down the Leer as well. Will dismiss away just in case there's another looming threat, but there's not. It's now down to two. As ENV decides to head back over to A, where TenZ has changed positions.
30
nice
seconds
shot
left.
Coming out from FNS, though. A quick flick over. And in the meantime, Crashies took care of the alarm bot and snuck his way up into heaven as well. With 22 seconds left, though, they need to make a move, and they've still got Omen sitting on the site. Shinobi just has to play this one patiently and wait for them to peek. There's the first one, and that's pretty much the round over.
10 seconds
Paranoia
left.
Goes a little bit too high. It goes over the head of Crashies. Boost a little slow on the flick over. TenZ had all the time in the world for that kill. And that sends ENV back yet again as they now try to go towards heaven. They're gonna have to deal with this Killjoy hardware. This utility coming out from Killjoy proving to be a serious nuisance for them as they try to work towards B. They're gonna have to wait for the nano swarm to dissipate. TenZ is waiting around the corner and the great flash to get some set up. And he's just gonna stick around. Even though that healing ray gives away his position, he's stuck into the corner and they don't.
The thing is here, Bok, the ones that are supposed to put up numbers for ENV as well are currently still practicing the cast. They're 0-6 next to Boots and mummAy. Now the blade storms are coming out too. The Relyks continues to hold his ground towards the A side as they are trying to push aggressively, falling off the blade storm. The attackers are trying to push through and mummAy gets picked off there and Shinobi dispatches him and exploded to the inside.
Nice cancel from Mitch as he stops that from happening. Takes down another target too as he goes for 180. The turret making it look easy right now.
30 seconds left.
The last remaining member is food in mid. And well, he's not really playing with the rest of the team. He was playing back off the play. He's going to leap his way through the ropes and try to make it up through heaven in time to try and make something happen. But with limited time left on the clock, the options are limited. And get caught going for a smoke as 10.
Shinobi is going to give that tell that they are trying to work towards his A side, but they still have three players there. So that's why nobody's rotating yet. And finally, the explosion is going to come in from ENV.
Relyks on site. He's got some backup as well from Shinobi. Relyks is able to find two, but Shinobi and Relyks both go down. Vice wants to eke through, but it doesn't work out so well. So ENV.
Spike planted.
Look at the plant out of this one. And we're seeing a little life from them. The heart rate monitor starting to just bleep just a bit. TenZ, he's got targets waiting around the corner. Mitch starting to come through from A ramp, goes ahead and drops the ult. There's the showstopper, but he prevents the rocket from coming out. Yet again, Kaboose goes for that ult and it doesn't work. And now that Killjoy ult comes through and makes this so much more difficult for mummAy. He has to try to run. It's so well played from Cloud9. If they had gotten that rocket off, even if he dies, but gets the rocket. It's a very slow, patient play, excuse me, for Cloud9. They peek their heads out, and they spot that first target. Now they know the jig is up. They realize that this is a force buy coming out from them. The flash comes through. Crashies is blind. His flash also delays them just a bit. The move bot, though, is going to trace his position. And just like that, they've gained up some sight control. The nade goes down, and it's a quick shot coming out from Vice. TenZ with the follow-up and towards this A site, ready for the explosion that's about to come their way. There's the Leer through. Food steps into the dark cover, doesn't work out so well.
10 seconds left.
The flying kill coming out from Crashies, who's found another. And now it's all up to Mitch, who gets taken down on the back lines. And
still gonna be Kaboose spotted first, but as he swings towards that right, his teammate's peeking out. And again, that duo working together to get that first kill.
I love that play too, to kind of get into that position with Kaboose just flying in with the blast pack to get an early positional advantage. Good damage coming out onto Relyks through the wall. He's got the frenzy right around the corner. The tripwire was down. Nice dink shot at least onto food. But a two-man advantage for ENV. Shinobi gonna try and work his way in with just a pistol. There's one on the balcony and one just nestled up behind the box. There's one sending in the boombot. It'll blow up actually right in the face of Kaboose, but by that point the rifle had already done the dirty work. Mitch, the only one surviving and trying to sneak into the site to potentially find a plant, does have at least some site control, but there's that paint shells going down. Could go for this plant potentially, but decides to just take for the...
Still going to be ENV putting up this fight. It's not over yet right now, as they're still given this mid control available for Cloud9, and they're just stacking up at sites. Cloud9 is just looking for an aggressive push here at this point. The smokes are coming soon.
Well, there's that Killjoy ult. We'll see if that's what it's going to take. Food is in position. Pinging out the turret, has to be careful as that ult is gonna connect. He's trying to get away, but
no,
he gets detained because he got slowed. So there's two players actually detained, and they're gonna blast him out of position. It's an easy couple of kills for them to gain access to the site. This could potentially be it. Cloud9 is gonna get a spike plant out of this, and it's a 4-on-3, and they've still got the Rolling Thunder to play with.
That is so unfortunate, but let's see what happens with the round now. With the attempt of a retake, only two players remaining. FNS,
off
the first
feet.
One to come out from the doorway. A Rolling Thunder here into the site. There's that first kill, but didn't connect onto the second one. It's still up to Crashy. Three versus one, spots the first. Vice falls. Now towards that B side, but this round, Kaboose pushing forward, already taking new control. But Relyks is close range, gets the buckshot in the face of Kaboose, and everybody's teleporting back towards the B side.
A nice way to kick things off here for the attacking side, though. They're going to manage to scoop up control of that B site. They'll go ahead and secure the spike as well. The pistol of TenZ eventually finds the kill. The heal will help, but it won't take them up to full reach. Sitting below 50 HP as they group up now and come through into Huga. They've actually managed to make this work. They've brought it down now to 2, and the Sova gets dropped down to just around 5 HP. Mummy's on site with a full poke, but he's got to be careful as the drone comes through. Look at the damage that's being dealt. Mummy somehow still alive. Has to go to the sidearm as he's down out of ammo. And there it is. Cloud9 make it work. It starts with the shotgun.
You can try to play like any type of flank play. So Cloud9 did a great job here to even things up on a 3-3 round, rather. A full save coming in for ENV as they lose one player early trying to take control of showers. Here.
That's what makes TenZ playing the Reyna so interesting. So for a long time, we've praised Jett as being one of the strongest initiators because of the escapability. Mm-hmm. Well, TenZ just illustrates that same trait with a character that also has a flash and a self-heal. As TenZ escapes with the discus like he's done many times in the past, as they try up on top of the truck, they've got the paranoia prepared, it comes through. And yeah, the initial few just completely obliterated. Now, Mummy does actually manage to spot Shinobi and take him down. TenZ is here, and he's still shooting him away. As the spike drops in an effort to try to get through the portal,
it's over! You're dead!
It just begins!
Well, there's the run it back being used as an opener. Kaboose is going to charge it first. Nope. The flash was on the money, but for some reason pulls out the knife to jump around the corner. Bit of an interesting decision. Showstopper, and it's perfect right on the money as Kaboose gobbled up the rocket. It's down to now just one for ENV. It's Crashies who's taking the portal and hoping to get a spike plant out of this scenario. Now, Crashies does have his ult available, so there is a chance that he could use that ult to try and prevent the spike from being defused, but he's going to have to do some serious legwork to get it to that point even. There's a perfect leer coming out. That's going to make things so much harder. Sure, he finds the kill, but look at the cost. 25 HP remains. Gets distracted by the leaping target, and Relyks will round the bend and close out another round here for Cloud9. That's 5 on the board.
Being punched in onto the spike. Cover going out. Into the B side. So again, that is ENV at that point. If they want to try one more time, they do have an auto security to work with to try to clear out that elbow. But they're going for at least this econ to start things off, this eco towards this A side. They force somewhat, they force no rotation actually, but they force a 4 versus 4 from that train. But like I said, into the next gun round, I'd like to see the Hunter's Fury to try to clear out Elbow if they're still trying to continue to work towards this long B for Envy.
Using that camera to get some intel. Look at the amount of utility out on the site from the Killjoy. The Nano Swarm does some damage as Mitch just starts spraying him down. Not able to finish off that third target, but does do pretty heavy damage. Food's gonna send a boom bot around the corner. And yikes, that shock dart makes it a little bit easier for Vice. It's down to just crashies, and it's another round for Cloud9. Echoes
up.
That ult doesn't go off. We saw that a couple times, a couple of canceled ults for the raise in the past. Vice from distance actually gonna land two pulses of the Hunter's Fury. That takes this from being an advantageous position for Envy to now being an even 2-on-2. Now Mummy's in heaven, and Crashies is able to sneak over towards that default position. We don't see the spike planted there all that often. I like the blast pack utilization that allows them to get into that spot. And the nade is actually good enough. And now Mummy, what is he going to be able to do here? Has to spam through the box. Actually does connect. So now it's down to the 1-on-1. They didn't get the spike to halfway. Fake port coming out. I like the move from Mummy. And he's just going to start spamming through. But Vice reads it well. And Mummy runs out of ammo. So 29 HP or 28 HP, excuse me, all that's left there. Well, it's going to be a clash on the B site as utility gets expended from both teams. There's the ult coming out from Mitch. Mitch taken down. The ult's going to get destroyed. There's still shinobi to deal with, and the fight ends up going the direction of Cloud9 at first. But then it spirals back to Envy's favor. The nade comes out, but it's a little too late to stop the plant. Relyks is swapped over to the up, and we'll see if that's going to be enough as he's not prepared for the peek coming out from Mummy. But Shinobi has to back off after that initial kill, and he does. Now, I love what we're seeing as well on the other side. You've got Mitch now pushed up in mid, ready to get the flank, but you've got Kaboose going in first, curveballing through the nade, and the curveball
30
not really going to produce much success. The Relyks picks off one, trying to find a follow-up by way of Shinobi. Shinobi's found two, and that's the spike planter going down.
Ball on that pistol round on that first half, just to give a better chance for your teammates who are rotating, get a better chance.
Ciao. Oof.
Relyks times that first shot, and somehow Mummy gets caught looking the wrong way. One as Relyks is cleaning up currently in hookah. Goes for that final kill, but not gonna
round to try to catch up and bring this into overtime. So far, it's looking to be in favor on paper of Cloud9 because of the weaponry that they have, and also from that entry kill as Kaboose falls. And now they continue to wallbang, and FNS never saw that coming. TenZ gets the wallbang, takes him down, and it's another 5-on-3 with an open sight into B.
You should run.
Oh, that's a great move from Food to get into hookah.
One enemy remaining.
And they're gonna keep making their way out, but my god. At least to a certain amount. Now, you do have the jump peek coming through, paranoia to back up Food, but Food is actually taken down as the spam allows them to trace that target back to its destination. And they make it a little bit easier for themselves. Now they pop one through the portal, and Shinobi's gonna back off as the rest of the team is starting to work up mid now, where you've got Phoenix positioned outside of Longport, and you've got Sova likely jump peeking on the B site, spotting towards hookah. And that's
30
exactly
seconds
what
left.
Happened. Crashies is looking for that intel, and he's gonna get it. So there's the recon dart coming out from Crashies, and he's gonna go area high to try and give away position. And that's in case they decide to jump out, but that makes it a little bit too easy there for Vice to take down Crashies. There's still positions being given away. The Emperor's ult has been popped, and it's now a 3-on-2 with numbers advantage for Cloud9.
10 seconds
spike
left.
Going down. Mummy has made
spike
it into
planted.
Hookah. With 10 seconds left, the spike touches pay dirt. Shots coming out through the dark cover puts Mummy down on a 5 HP, and that puts a lot of pressure on FNS to save the day. The Nano Swarm making it that much harder for FNS to move into position, and now the Hunter's Fury as well. Nothing can be done.
Attacker
Cloud9 moves things out